I get my inspiration mostly from music, beats of the music, how the music elevates from like a riff to another, from a beat to another. All of these levels make the lines like kind of interact to each other. And from there, a hit piece is born. Growing up in Egypt was not the right place for me because of my sexuality. The way I dress, the way I look, the way I act, I couldn't be free. After I came to the States, I used to do costumes as a hobby. I started like freelancing and doing gigs on the side. For me, it's not just a costume. For me, it's so many things together. It's like an idea, an inspiration. It's art, it's sculpting. I want to like tell a story behind the headpiece. If you can like put it in your body and you move with it, it actually makes you feel great. Glamorous and fabulous, of course. In Egypt, we have this law, it's called emergency law. It gives the authority for the police to arrest you with no accusation. It was like 12 a.m., 1 a.m. at night. I was with a guy in a car. We kissed. All of a sudden, I see a police car coming from nowhere. Four policemen came out of it. The head of the police officer stood there and he told me, if you told me if you're gay or not, I'm gonna let you go. And if you didn't tell me, I'm gonna take you with me right now. So he forced me to tell him. He slapped me again until I confessed and I told him, yes, I'm gay. He took me to the police station, handcuffed in a car. I was just shaking the entire time. They kept me in this room after I was arrested. They slapped me, they humiliated me. I stayed there for a week. They fed me nothing but water and bread. I hear stuff that they killed gay guys. I hear stories that they beat them up till death. All what I could think of is just like, if any power could save me right now, I wish I could be alive. I was lucky because he called my family. My family came and picked me up. My mom thought that I was sick and I should be cured. At this time, when I figured out like I cannot stay here. I booked the first flight and I left. I applied for asylum in the US, where I got accepted. I always feel that there was always something better for me, waiting for me in the future. I always look at the bigger picture that I deserve better. I deserve to be somewhere where I belong, somewhere where I feel happy and safe and secure. And I knew this place was not Egypt. I came out on social media. It's actually the most beautiful thing that ever happened to me in my entire life because I got like good comments. People that appreciated what I wrote. Like all these people that came out of nowhere that I didn't know anything about their lives. And they're like, your post inspired us so much. I think the LGBT community in Egypt would maybe get better if there was enough effort from so many of us that can speak up. 1 year ago, started like freelancing and doing gigs on the side, like for photo shoots and hit pieces. I did a couple of stuff for Sasha Velour, like the finale for season 10 of RuPaul. After that, I met a designer and he told me, do you want to do this for Miss Universe Iraq? This is like the biggest gig that I got for the first time in costume designing. That was definitely like an amazing moment for me. I have these moments all the time. I wake up one day and I just look at my left, you're doing what you love and you came here to a country that you dream to live in. You're having the people that accepting you and not judging you based on your sexuality. People love you for who you are. And I don't regret any risk that I took to come out or like come to the States. I feel how grateful I am for everything.